Welcome to Pierce County Talks. The county expects substantial population growth over the next few decades, and making sure our local roads can handle that load is vital. County officials are doing that planning now. Heather Radall tells us more about the update to the transportation portion of the comprehensive plan.
Traffic patterns have changed a lot since Pierce County's transportation plan was created for the unincorporated areas in 1992. This 8 a.m. commute on Canyon Road East and 112th Street is a good example.
So in 1992, there was only about 24,000 vehicles traveling on this roadway on Canyon Road East, right around this area. At this time, you see 48,000 vehicles traveling.
Canyon Road East is also a good example of a project that was put in the 92 plan and built, widening it from 4 lanes to 7 lanes. But the number of cars continues to grow.
We project that by 2030, because that is really the out year for the transportation plan, there'll be as many as 56,000 vehicles traveling the road.
Minor updates to the transportation plan happen every year. The county uses it as a roadmap to meet demand. It lays out where growth and congestion are occurring and which roads will need repairs. Since there's a limit to the number of lanes the county can add at any given street, the 2015 transportation plan must also focus on other ways to relieve congestion.
I think that certainly there'll be places where we will need to widen certain roadways, but those widenings will be limited, more limited than they have been in the past, in part because that's what they're needed, and there'll probably be a proposal for a higher tolerance for roadway congestion in itself.
The plan also calls for more corridor connectivity, encouraging non-motorized travel and public transit, and improving safety on the roads. The challenge, the county says, will be finding the money to pay for the costly improvements.
Do you raise revenues? Do you cut costs? And what is the balance for that? That is a real transportation challenge, I see.
For Pierce County Talks, I'm Heather Radall.
The transportation plan update is going through a series of meetings and work sessions and will then be presented to the County Council for review and adoption. Joining me today is Pierce County Councilmember Doug Richardson and Pierce County Director of Public Works Brian Ziegler. Welcome to the program.
Thanks for having us.
Doug, what is the purpose of the transportation plan?
Well, technically it's a transportation element of the comprehensive plan, which we're required to undertake by law. And the County Council will get the comprehensive plan in June of this year. And the transportation element of that is really key. We haven't updated it since 1992. And what it is it's a look at the state of the transportation system, really, where we are, where we want to go, and how we're going to get there out into the future in regard to transportation. So it's one of the 8 required elements of the comprehensive plan that's required under the Growth Management Act. So that's really what we're dealing with.
Do each of the 8 elements get an equal treatment as this one seems to be getting?
Well, they all go in front of the Planning Commission before they come to the County Council. And in coordination with Planning and Land Services, they pull all those 8 elements together as part of the comprehensive plan update. So they're all looked at pretty closely. But transportation, needless to say, is a very, very large and important. But remember that what it is, it's really melding land use planning, which is, you know, projection of population growth and what your land uses are, which also then you tie your transportation element to that, to how you're going to move people, you know, based on how many folks we have and where they live and where businesses are and all those kinds of things. So it's a great chance to look holistically at growth in Pierce County.
We don't want to build a road that goes to nowhere, right? Brian, let me ask you how extensive the plan is. I think Doug alluded to it. Does it include freeways and other major arteries? Or are we talking mainly the county roads and bridges and so forth?
Well, David, the principal focus is county roads because we can make decisions about county roads and whether to build them or not, whether to widen them or not, in support of the land use element of the comprehensive plan. But we can't make those decisions in a vacuum. We clearly have to connect county roads to city streets. We have to connect the county roads to the state highway system and the freeways. So our engineers are modeling or examining the transportation system as a network and then extracting the Pierce County road side of that so we can make decisions about it.
Well, since some of those other roads are under other auspices and other control, how does that affect your ability to plan and put this together?
Well, that's a real challenge. The planning has to be coordinated with the state, with all the cities in Pierce County. And it's not just transportation. We have to coordinate our land use and our population allocations. So it's really critical that all the jurisdictions communicate on all of those eight elements in the comprehensive plan.
And as an example, there's transportation package pending right now down in Olympia, which a key element of that is completion of 167. And then, of course, we need to talk about completing North Canyon Road to connect to 167 because it's a logical way, to move east-west. So it's important to take all that into consideration. We also need to talk about I-5 on the, JBLM corridor. Those improvements are also part of the state plan because if we're ever going to have a cross-base highway or anything like that, it has to connect to I-5, right? So
right. You
need to take it all into account.
Does the plan take into account non-vehicular items such as pedestrian, mass transit, that sort of thing?
Well, as I mentioned before, it is a network, county, city, and state, and it also carries multiple modes. Freight is a big component for economic development. Bicycles are an important element for commuters and recreational use. Sidewalks are important, and of course, mass transit. They all use the same corridor, the same road, and we need to accommodate not only single-occupant vehicles, but all the other partners, so to speak, on the roadways.
So all of that goes into this element?
Yes, right? And again, it rolls into the comprehensive plan, but to go a little further with Brian's remarks, a couple of initiatives underway. There's been a long-established Safe Routes to Schools program funded by the state, which, tries to provide non-motorized, sidewalks, obviously, going to and from schools. And last year, the Pierce County Council set aside $250,000 for the Public Works to take a look at where we might be able to use that to match some grants in order to provide that safe transportation to schools. And right now, Brian's department has an initiative underway where they've already made contact with three superintendents in unincorporated Pierce County to have them prioritize where they'd want to have sidewalks if they could in their school. So again, a comprehensive look at the entire transportation system.
This is a huge undertaking.
Yes, it is.
I don't know how you keep track of it all.
Well, we have lots of help. This is a multidisciplinary, multi-agency effort. And as Councilmember Richardson said, we haven't really done a comprehensive review since 1992. So there's a lot of work to do. And we started several years ago in anticipation of this. And we're getting near to the end now. It's looking pretty good.
And we've always met the legal requirement. But this is going to be the best synchronization we've had in a long time, again, because we're tying in the land use piece with the transportation piece at the same time. It's going to be very good for us, I think.
You mentioned Canyon Road. That was part of my commute this morning, and I got on it at the wrong time, and I was late for work. So what is the biggest transportation challenges you see at this point as you're working on this plan?
Well, we're looking out 15 years and trying to predict the future, and there are three major desires, I would say, of Pierce County citizens. They want their roads to be safe, they want them to be smooth and open, especially during snow and ice storms, and they want the multiple mode capabilities there. So we've identified some expansion, some additions, and some new corridors like Canyon Road extension to the north that would meet those needs, but we're fiscally constrained. In addition to doing travel demand forecasts, we're forecasting how much money is going to come in. And the reality is that under current scenarios, there isn't enough to do everything. So we've got to make some trade-offs.
And part of that has to be dealing with congestion relief as well. I mean, obviously, you're projecting out 15 years or so. We know the population of Pierce County is going to grow. We'll probably have 1 million residents in the next 20 years. So that has to be taken into account. And the county council formed a transportation benefit district last year. We haven't yet funded it, But the purpose for the Transportation Benefit District is to try to identify revenue that can be used to, again, match grant funds that have been coming in that we've been able to do on Canyon Road for some time. But we need some additional revenue to keep that going.
As you forecast out, what do you think will be the major concerns, say, in 2025, 2030? Any idea what those might be?
Well. Current on steroids.
Crystal ball time.
Well, we think we've got the revenues, as Councilmember Richardson was saying, to do the important things. Keep the roads smooth, keep them paved, keep them snow and ice control, cut the brush back. Where we're going to be a little bit short in the future is in those big economic development investments. Somebody 15 years ago had the foresight, the county council, to enact revenues that enabled us to match large grants from the state and federal government. It's the only way we could have widened Canyon the way we did. It's the only way we could have widened 176th. It's the only way we could have done Wallachet. All those big corridor projects have far more state and federal money in them than they have local money. But you gotta have the local money there to leverage it.
You gotta be able to match those monies in order to use them.
Correct.
Right, and it doesn't have to be a match dollar for dollar, but there's generally a requirement of X dollars in match from the local government.
Does this plan evolve from year to year? How fluid is it?
Well, the transportation element, we don't redo the comprehensive plan every year, so that's a long-range plan. But in the Public Works Department, we have the Transportation Improvement Program. There are, you touch that thing annually to see, okay, this is where we said we were going. Operationally now, what projects are we going to undertake? Those kinds of things, I think, is a fair...
Yes, it might be a 15-year plan, but it's not one decision for 15 years.
Right.
It's a 15-year look. It's a guidepost, right?
Correct.
A guidepost. And if something was to happen and say, oh, well, we didn't even see this particular corridor coming up, you could quickly shift gears and move forward.
Or more likely, we receive funding for a corridor that might not have been number one on the list, but we got the funding and we're going to move out on that.
Okay, so priority shift and things move around.
That's one reason we do a transportation improvement program every year and are required by state law to do that, so we can adjust.
I think you mentioned this briefly, Doug. What happens to this element then? It goes to the comprehensive plan and then?
Well, it goes to the Planning Commission for review, then it'll come up to Community Development Committee of the council, and then it'll be heard by the full council, and then we'll adopt the comprehensive plan and transmit it to PSRC.
The regional council,
right.
How can the public get involved in these discussions and ideas?
Well, the public has been involved for several years now, both on the transportation and comprehensive plan side, particularly with the land use advisory commissions. During the public hearings at the council, that's another opportunity. They can always go to the Pierce County website and review all the documents. Those will be updated as decisions are made, so that's probably the best source of most current information.
And that's Planning and Land Services.
Correct.
Where you go, and the comp plan amendments would be there. The transportation element, all of it's available on the way. It's really a well-done website, and that's a good place for people to go. And again, the Land Use Advisory Committee meetings, the Planning Commission meetings are open to the public, Community Development Committee meetings, and also the full council itself.
Good. Thank you both for being in with us today, and good luck on the transportation element of the comprehensive plan.
Thank you, David.
Great.
Thanks, David.